Weekly Artificial Intelligence News. Hello, viewers. Welcome back to your one-stop shop for all news AI. We're back once more with the latest, sometimes shocking happenings of the artificial intelligence universe. From working towards building smarter AI, artificial neurons going quantum, and safeguarding neural networks from attacks, all the way to using natural eye movement for training metaverse platforms and computer chips that will predict the future of gene synthesis, we have it all and more. So, without further ado, let's jump right into our weekly updates. However, before we do, we request you to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss another upload of ours. Having said that, let's get right to it. Highlights of the week. Hybrid human-machine framework for building smarter AI. From chatbots that answer tax questions to algorithms that drive autonomous vehicles and dish out medical diagnoses, artificial intelligence undergirds many aspects of daily life. Creating smarter, more accurate systems requires a hybrid human-machine approach, according to researchers at the University of California, Irvine. In a study published this month in Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, they present a new mathematical model that can improve performance by combining human and algorithmic predictions and confidence scores. Humans and machine algorithms have complementary strengths and weaknesses. Each uses different sources of information and strategies to make predictions and decisions, said co-author Mark Stavers, UCI professor of cognitive sciences. We show through empirical demonstrations, as well as theoretical analyses, that humans can improve the predictions of AI even when human accuracy is somewhat below that of the AI, and vice versa. And this accuracy is higher than combining predictions from two individuals or two AI algorithms. To test the framework, researchers conducted an image classification experiment in which human participants and computer algorithms worked separately to correctly identify distorted pictures of animals and everyday items – chairs, bottles, bicycles, trucks. The human participants ranked their confidence in the accuracy of each image classification as low, medium, or high, while the machine classifier generated a continuous score. The results showed large differences in confidence between humans and AI algorithms across images. When predictions and confidence scores from both were combined using the researchers' new Bayesian framework, the hybrid model led to better performance than either human or machine predictions achieved alone. Artificial neurons going quantum with photonic circuits. In recent years, artificial intelligence has become ubiquitous, with applications such as speech interpretation, image recognition, medical diagnosis, and many more. At the same time, quantum technology has been proven capable of computational power well beyond the reach of even the world's largest supercomputer. Physicists at the University of Vienna have now demonstrated a new device, called quantum memristor, which may allow to combine these two worlds, thus unlocking unprecedented capabilities. The experiment, carried out in collaboration with the National Research Council, CNR, and the Politecnico di Milano in Italy, has been realized on an integrated quantum processor operating on single photons. The work is published in the current issue of the journal Nature Photonics. At the heart of all artificial intelligence applications are mathematical models called neural networks. These models are inspired by the biological structure of the human brain, made of interconnected nodes. Just like our brain learns by constantly rearranging the connections between neurons, neural networks can be mathematically trained by tuning their internal structure until they become capable of human-level tasks, recognizing our face, interpreting medical images for diagnosis, even driving our cars. Having integrated devices capable of performing the computations involved in neural networks quickly and efficiently has thus become a major research focus, both academic and industrial. One of the major game changers in the field was the discovery of the memristor, made in 2008. This device changes its resistance depending on a memory of the past current, hence the name memory resistor or memristor. Immediately after its discovery, scientists realized that, among many other applications, the peculiar behavior of memristors was surprisingly similar to that of neural synapses. The memristor has thus become a fundamental building block of neuromorphic architectures. Making deep neural networks safe from attacks. If a sticker on a banana can make it show up as a toaster, how might strategic vandalism warp how an autonomous vehicle perceives a stop sign? Now, an immune-inspired defense system for neural networks can ward off such attacks, designed by engineers, biologists, and mathematicians at the University of Michigan. Deep neural networks are a subset of machine learning algorithms used for a wide variety of classification problems. These include image identification and machine vision, used by autonomous vehicles and other robots, natural language processing, language translation, and fraud detection. However, it is possible for a nefarious person or a group to adjust the input slightly and send the algorithm down the wrong train of thought, so to speak. To protect algorithms against such attacks, the Michigan team developed the Robust Adversarial Immune-Inspired Learning System. RAILS represents the very first approach to adversarial learning that is modeled after the adaptive immune system, which operates differently than the innate immune system, said Alfred Hero, the John H. Holland Distinguished University Professor, who co-led the work published in IEEE Access. While the innate immune system mounts a general attack on pathogens, the mammalian immune system can generate new cells designed to defend against specific pathogens. It turns out that deep neural networks, already inspired by the brain's system of information processing, can take advantage of this biological process too. Simulated human eye movement to train metaverse platforms. Computer engineers at Duke University have developed virtual eyes that simulate how humans look at the world accurately enough for companies to train virtual reality and augmented reality programs. Called iSIN for short, the program will help developers create applications for the rapidly expanding metaverse while protecting user data. The results have been accepted and will be presented at the International Conference on Information Processing in Sensor Networks, a leading annual forum on research in network sensing and control. If you're interested in detecting whether a person is reading a comic book or advanced literature by looking at their eyes alone, you can do that, said Maria Gorlatova, the Nortel Network's assistant professor of electrical and computer engineering at Duke. But training that kind of algorithm requires data from hundreds of people wearing headsets for hours at a time, Gorlatova added. We wanted to develop software that not only reduces the privacy concerns that come with gathering this sort of data, but also allows smaller companies who don't have those level of resources to get into the metaverse game. The poetic insight describing eyes as the windows to the soul has been repeated since at least biblical times for good reason. The tiny movements of how our eyes move and pupils dilate provide a surprising amount of information. Human eyes can reveal if we're bored or excited, where concentration is focused, whether or not we're expert or novice at a given task, or even if we're fluent in a specific language. Eye movement data is invaluable to companies building platforms and software in the metaverse. For example, reading a user's eyes allows developers to tailor content to engagement responses or reduce resolution in their peripheral vision to save computational power. Computer chip to predict the future of gene synthesis? Creating synthetic life could be easily within our grasp soon based on a comparison with the evolution of computer chips. Computer programming and gene synthesis appear to share little in common. But according to University of Cincinnati professor Andrew Steckel, an Ohio eminent scholar, leaps forward in technology in the former make him optimistic that wide-scale gene manufacture is achievable. Steckel and his student, Joseph Riolo, used the history of microchip development and large-scale computer software platforms as a predictive model to understand another complex system, synthetic biology. Steckel said the project was inspired by comments by another student in his group, Elliot Gomez. No analogy is perfect. DNA doesn't meet certain definitions of digital code, Riolo said, but there are a lot of ways the genome and software code are comparable. According to the UC study, synthetic biology has the potential to be the next epochal technological human advancement following microelectronics and the internet. Its applications are boundless, from creating new biofuels to developing new medical treatments. Scientists at the J. Craig Venter Institute created the first synthetic organism in 2010 when they transplanted an artificial genome of Mycoplasma mycoides into another bacterial cell. This relatively simple artificial genome took 15 years to develop at a cost of more than $40 million. But by using computer chip development as a guide, Seckel said, we can infer the speed and costs of producing similar synthetic life might follow a similar trajectory as the performance and cost of electronics over time. With that, we come to the end of today's video. consider subscribing to join in next time for more of such interesting AI-centric content.